kind of problems are happening, like coronavirus that is spreading everywhere. Obviously, it's been blown out of proportion. But even then, Islam has directed us, instructed us, has given us guidelines, very clear guidelines. So we need to follow them. And in this kind of situation, the Prophet ﷺ has said, when sins become prevalent, rife in the community, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send these kind of plague, these kind of problems, these kind of disasters, these viruses in the midst of the people. And this is what's happening. So in this kind of situation, first of all, what we need to make sure is, we need to make sure we do istighfar and tawbah. Because many a times we tend to blame other people. Zuhar al-fasad fil barri wal bahri bima kasabat aydin nas. That the fasad, the corruption which is apparent on the earth and on the sea is because of the deeds, misdeeds, the evil that we commit ourselves. We don't blame ourselves, we blame other people. So this blame game all the time, we say, no, these people in China, they were doing that. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, instead of pointing a finger at them, let us point a finger at ourselves and see where are we going wrong. This is the way we need to correct and rectify ourselves. So first thing is tawbah istighfar. We need to make sure that we do tawbah istighfar for our sins. Secondly, we need to give sadaqah in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because sadaqah, badiru bis sadaqah, fa innal bala'a la yatakhattaha. That be quick in giving sadaqah. Because the calamities, they will not able to surpass. So in other words, the sadaqah will stop the calamity coming. So that's why sadaqah is very important. That it says, tadfa'u ghadab ar-rab. That the sadaqah will stop the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it will also stop a person from having a bad death. So sadaqah should be given all the time. We don't realize that how important sadaqah is. When we give in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are two angels who come down every day. One angel, he keeps on praying, Allahumma a'ti munfiqan khalafa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give the person who is giving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him a good reward. And those people who don't give, the bakhil, the ones who are the miser, the hadith mentions that the angel prays, Allahumma a'ti munsikan talafa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give the person who withholds, who doesn't give in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him destruction. So we need to be a nation who is always generous. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, kana ajwad an-nas, wa kana ahsan an-nas, wa kana asja' an-nas. He was the one who was the most generous. He was the one who was the best in akhlaq. He was the best in, he was the one who was the most brave. So these qualities we need to get into ourselves. So the second thing is giving sadaqah in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thirdly, in these kind of situations, we need to make sure the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us that prevention is better than cure. So we need to make sure that we use the preventative measures. In Islam subhanallah, now the medical experts, World Health Organization, they're explaining that this is the methods that you should be using. These are the preventative measures. These are the safety methods. So basically, Islam has already taught us. If a person is performing his five-time prayers, he'll be washing his hands five times anyhow. He'll be washing his hands all the time. Islam has taught us when a person goes into the bathroom, he will clean himself with water. He'll make sure he washes his hand. When he is eating food, subhanAllah, Islam has taught us. Barakatu ta'am al-wudu qablahu al-wudu ba'dahu. That the barakat of the food is to wash your hands before and to wash it afterwards. Islam has taught us all these kind of things. If a person follows these rules, a person who's sneezing, what does Islam teach us? A person should cover it with the tissue, with his hands, to subdue the noise and not to spread the virus to anybody else. So this is the point. This Islam has already taught us through our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam 1400 years ago. So the point here is, if we want to be successful in this world and the hereafter, the best way forward is to follow the teachings of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this true religion. Subhanallah, I was in Bangladesh last week. So we were coming from a place called Cox Bazar. When we were coming, we saw a coach just collided and it fell into the ditch. So we went to see what the situation is, to try to save the people there. So we found the people all scattered on the ground. And some were, obviously they were all crying and screaming. Some broke their backs, some broke their hands, some broke their legs. So we went to see what we could do. We brought some water bottles and we were trying to comfort them. So when we managed to get other people to come, we phoned the police, we phoned the people, we told the, all the transport people to come and help them, to take them to hospitals. So these gentlemen, the men, they came and we realized they were Hindus. They were not Muslims. They just came from the places of worship, from the synagogues and the temples. So basically, they were just coming from the worship. So when I was leaving, they looked at me and they said, "You're going?" I said, "Yeah, we need to go. We've got a place to visit. So basically, we have already organized people to come and take you to the hospitals." So he goes, "Please don't go." They said, "Please don't go." I said, "Why?" He goes, "Please, will you pray to your God Allah that He takes away this difficulty from us?" So these people have just worshipped. They're gods, they have just come. But I stayed away. I said, "Alhamdulillah, Allah has given us this true religion. That even those people who are worshipping their gods, they don't have that yaqeen on their gods. They have the yaqeen on God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." That's an amazing thing. So this is a point that we need to get into our minds. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the best of religion. Inna deena inda Allah al-Islam. Not only the best, the true, only true religion. Inna deena inda Allah al-Islam. And this is the point that we need to get into our minds. Our brothers and sisters, our youngsters who go to school as well. Because they will teach you the comparative religion. You follow whatever religion, there's no problem. But we need to get this in our children's mind. That the only true religion, only accepted religion, only authorless, only genuine religion is Islam. وَمَنْ يَبْدَلْ غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنِي. A person who searches for any other religion other than Islam, it will never be accepted. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. In the hereafter, he'll be from the losers. So this is the main point that we have to keep in mind, that in this kind of situation, we need to make sure that we follow the guidelines of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And other things they have said is already mentioned. Like for example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you hear about a waba, a virus, an endemic, any kind of illness, any kind of problem which is happening in a community, any virus which has spread it out, then the people who are there, they should not be coming out. The people from outside, they should not go in. That has been given the instructions from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So all these points have been already mentioned. So this is what these people are applying. So if you look deeply into all those points that even the health experts, the medical experts, they are saying, these have been all been mentioned by our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Islam has taught all of these things. So coming away from the topic,